Hi all and welcome to OrganoMed. So in this video I had shown you molecular docking using Autodock Vena. So as all of you are aware that Autodock Vena is the best available academic software for molecular docking, and in the previous video of Autodock I had also told you all that I will make a separate video on Autodock Vena. So here is the video. I try to make this video in the best and easy way so that everyone will be able to perform the molecular docking using Autodock Vena. As all of you know that it runs under command prompt, and many people used to face some difficulty while running command prompt. So I had made this video in a very simplest way so that you will be able to perform docking. Alright, I'm pretty much sure that after watching this video you will be able to run Autodock Vena. So how did you like this video? Please comment down in the comment section. If you have any queries regarding the video, you can mail on organomed2020@gmail.com, and you can also message your queries on Instagram handle, that is organomed2020. So I hope all of you will like this video, go through the video and enjoy molecular docking. Now let's proceed to the video. First of all, we need to install Autodock Vena. So in the Google homepage, load down as Autodock Vena. So you can see this kind of interface will open. Hit Autodock Vena. It will open the home screen. So you can see this is the home screen of Autodock Vena, and we need to download it. So move on to the download section. And here you will find Autodock Vena for various operating system, Windows, Linux and Mac. So for, alright, so here I have Windows, so I will hit Autodock Vena for Windows 32 system. And you can see it has been downloaded. Alright, so the software Autodock Vena has been downloaded, and now we need to install it. So just double click on it. Alright, so it is preparing to install. It will ask permission, then hit OK. So it will ask permission, so hit yes. So Vena has been installed successfully, and we can check our program files where we had installed Vena. So under default settings, Vena used to download in the program files. So click program files, and then you will find the Scripps Research Institute. Hit it, and then here you will find Vena. Alright, so this is the Vena. So this is the Vena application. This is the Vena split application, and it is the license. Now the first thing which you need to do is you need to copy all these three, and you need to paste them under the docking folder. So this is the docking folder, and we need to place our three Vena softwares. So this is the docking folder, and here you need to paste these Vena executable files. All right, and now so we have all these important softwares in a single folder, and what we need to do is we need to download our protein and ligand of choice for molecular docking. Alright, so for that, move on to Google and then write down as RCSV bank, RCSV protein data bank. Here you need to download your protein of choice. So at present I want a pain-like protease from COVID-19, and its PDB ID is 4OVZ. So here you can see 4OVZ X-ray crystals, X-ray structural and biological evaluation of a series of potent and highly selective inhibitors of human coronavirus papain-like proteases. Right? So I need this protein for docking. And I need to download this, so I will download it in PDB format. Alright, so it is downloading, and now in the bottom, if you want to search for the active site or binding site, you can go for the literature search here. And this is the papain-like protease present in chain A, alright, and it is from SARS coronavirus. And you will find various small entities here. So this one is the main identity, that is P85. You can open it. Yes, so it's the structure of P85. And if you want to know the protein ligand interaction, so you can click on ligand interaction, and here you will find the interaction which this ligand makes. Alright, so you can see here it's the interaction diagram in 3D. Alright, and here are some data enclosed. You can go through it downloading. So now here you can see the protein has been downloaded, and the next thing which we need for docking is the ligand. So for ligand, here I had chosen Jing database. Jing is also a large database of chemical libraries. And move on to substances. So here, if you know the Jing ID, you can directly put it. So for now, I know the Jing ID. So I will just go down at 16287. 3816287. So it's the Jing ID of ligand. Alright, so you can see it is exited. Just open it, and you can download it from the download section in SDF format. So you have your SNILES ID also given, and you will find various other informations here, like the PKI value and log P values and all that. Alright, so we have our protein downloaded, and we also have our ligand downloaded. Alright, so now we will move on to the download section, and so here is the protein and here is the ligand. Just copy both these and paste it in the docking folder. So now you can see I had my protein in the PDB format and ligand in SDF format. And the most important thing I had told you earlier also in AutoDoc video, that while docking we need protein and ligand in PDB format. So first thing we need to do is we need to convert this ligand in. So first thing we need to do is we need to convert this ligand from SDF to PDB format. So for that, I told you that I find OpenBabel to be quite easy for conversion, and so I'm using OpenBabel here. Yeah, so it's the OpenBabel homepage. And the input format is SDF and the output format is PDB. It's just perfect. So I'm just going to choose the ligand. So it's this here. After this, you need to put your output file where you need to place it. So I need to place it in docking folder itself, but I want to change the name from Jing to ligand. So I'll just wrote down as ligand, and it will be saved in PDB format. Alright, so just save, and after that click on convert. Alright, so you can see a ligand has been converted, and now we will see it. here I have my ligand in the PDB format and the protein in PDB format. Alright, so now we have all the necessary thing with us. Alright, so now we have both the protein and ligand in PDB format, and now we will proceed for protein preparation. Now for protein preparation, I am going to show you a new software which I am choosing today for protein preparation, and it is BioVia Discovery Studio. I will provide the link of the software in a description box. You can download it from there. It's a free software and you can easily download it and install it. So today I'm going to use this BioVia Discovery Studio for protein preparation. Although we can prepare our protein using AutoDoc and PyMol also, but I thought it will be new if I use Discovery Studio. So this is the home page of BioVia Discovery Studio, and here you need to open your file. And here you need to open your protein. So click on open and then choose your folder, that is docking 4VZ, hit open. Alright, so you can see this is the protein. Right, so there are some arrows which I want to dictate here. This one is used to rotate, so if you choose it, you will be able to rotate the protein. After this, it is translate, and you can, if you want to move the position from here to here, if you want to move the position, you can choose it. And this one is used to zoom in and zoom out. All right, so yeah. So we are done with this, and now I need rotate. So after this, click on view and then hit hierarchy. Alright, so once you hit it, it will show you a protein tray, which is really very useful in protein preparation because we need to see the chains and water molecules and all that. So the first thing which we will do here is we will delete the water molecules present in the protein. So just select water molecules and then edit, and then hit delete. Alright, so you can see all the water molecules has been deleted. After this, there are some het atoms. There is chain A and chain B. There is active sites, if you will see. So it will show you all the active sites. So BioVia Discovery Studio is also helpful if you want to know the active sites in the protein. Alright. So you can see this yellow portion is showing you the active site. After this, it's here, and the third one is here, this ligand. All right, and after this, it's here. So you can see all the active sites under this protein. Alright, so you can see these two ligands, actually these are nothing but P85 molecule which we had seen. Actually these are nothing but the P85 molecules which we had seen in the protein literature. Alright, and so after that, click on ligand groups, and here we will find all the ligands. So this one is ligand 1, and this is ligand 2, and this is ligand 3. Now this 4, 5, 6 are the small molecules. So BioVia Discovery Studio provides lots of information regarding the protein which you will not find in AutoDoc. Alright, so I find preparing protein under BioVia Discovery Studio is quite easy, I would say that. Alright, so now I will select this ligand 1. Also, if you will see chain A, so it will show you all the amino acids residues, and if you will see this, so it will show you the small entities. So here is zinc. All right, it's zinc, and after this P85, and you can see this one is a P85, and this one is DMS, dimethyl sulfate. All right, so I need to select this, and this is actually, and this is nothing but ligand 1. All right, so first of all I will select this ligand 1, and I will remove it from here. Right. After that, select ligand 1, and then from receptor ligand interaction, move on to define and edit binding site, and here selecting ligand 1, click on from current selection. Okay, so you can see this kind of circle will appear, and it will cover the ligand. All right, so you can see this, and now this is actually the place where we need to dock our ligand. So what we will do is we will remove this ligand from here, and we will dock our ligand of choice in this position. All right, also I want to cover this ligand under this box, so I will expand this under this structure. So for that, click on SBD site sphere, and from here click on SBD site sphere, and then click expand. So it will increase the size. Okay, and you can see now we have both these ligand, that is ligand 1, 2 and ligand 3 under this sphere. All right, and now what we will do, we will remove these ligand, and we will dock our ligand of choice in this area. So after this, what you need to do is you need to select it and then hit attributes of SBD site sphere. Okay, so it will show you the X, Y and Z dimensions. All right, and these dimensions, and we will put these dimensions in our Veena configuration. All right, so this is the site where we will do docking. So we will select these three. So we will select these X, Y and Z coordinates from here, and we will apply, so we will apply these coordinates in grid configuration. All right, so click on OK. And after that, as I told you, we need to delete these ligand groups. So select ligand groups and then go on to edit, and click on edit and then delete. All right, so you can see all the ligand groups are deleted now. After this, I don't want chain B, so I will delete this chain B, also this. All right, so now we have chain A, we have het atoms, we have active sites, we have protein groups and this site sphere. Now the next thing which we used to do is we used to add polar hydrogens. All right, so in order to add polar hydrogens, you need to go into chemistry, and here you will find hydrogens, then hit add polar. All right, so now polar hydrogens has been added. All right, it is not showing you here because it is in a chain form. All right, if we change the structure, like say display style and this, so you can see in this form all the polar hydrogens has been added. All right, so now what you need to do is you need to save it. After this, we need to save this in PDB format. So we will go on to file and save. All right, so now I want to save this in terms of protein, so I will write down as protein, and I want to save it in protein data bank files, that is in PDB format. So from here select PDB, and now this 4OBZ will be saved as protein in PDB format. So hit save. All right, after this you can see the docking folder. So here we have protein in PDB format and ligand in PDB format, and now we will, and now our protein has been prepared, and we will prepare ligand in Autodoc files, MGL tools. So now let's open our Autodoc software. All right, So here is the Autodoc software. All right, hit remind me later. And so this one is the display of Autodoc tool. All right, so after this, you need to open your file, click on red molecule, and then choose the protein. So you can see this is a prepared protein, and you will check it. It has only chain A, all right? And polar hydrogens has been added. So after that, what we need to do is you need to add charges. So add Coleman charges, and then compute Gastiger charges. All right. So charges has been added. After this, click on atoms and then assign AD4 type. Alright, and now finally we need to save it in the PDBQT format. Alright, so click on atom and then press shift and then click end. Alright, and then add it. After that, click OK. Alright, so now if you will see your docking folder, we have generated our PDBQT. So here is the protein, and it is in PDBQT. And it is in PDBQT format. All right. So we have our protein generated in PDBQT format. After that, click on ligand and then input and then open. So you need to change from PBD. You need to change here from PDBQT to PDB format. And then select ligand, hit open. So the ligand molecules, and it will show you Gastiger charges has been added, and they had detected 6 rotatable bonds, and they had shed the TOS drop to 5. All right, so click OK, and after that I need to zoom it. All right, yes, after that click on ligand and then torsion tree and then detect root. All right, so you can see this kind, so you will see. After that, torsion tree, choose root. If you want to change the, if you want to change your torsions, you can change it from here. So the green bonds which you can see are the rotatable bonds. All right, and if you want to change it, you can change from here. All right. Now after this, you need to save the ligand in PDBQT format. So just wrote down as ligand.pdbqt. All right, and then save it. All right, so now we have protein and ligand both in PDBQT format. Now the most important step towards Veena is the grid and the configuration of the grid. All right, so here click on macromolecule. So here under grid, choose macromolecule and then open. All right, not. So under the grid section, click on macromolecule and then choose. So choose the protein from here. All right. And okay. All right. So click on protein and it will save. Yes. All right. So now we had chosen the macromolecule, and after that set map types and choose ligand. So choose the ligand. This you need a configuration file. So I have a configuration file already ready here, and I will give you this format in the description box, so it will be helpful to all of you. So here in this receptor, you have to write the name of the receptor, and you have to give the center XYZ, Also, you have to give the size, that is radius. And at last, you have to give the exhaustiveness, all right? That is the number of times you want to run Autodoc Vena in order to get the final results. So now, in this receptive file, you need to, right, the first thing what I'm going to do is I want to copy it from here. Docking and then place it here. Alright, so this one is the configuration file. Open this and now you need to, so you can see in this configuration file, you need to write the receptor in PDBQT format, ligand in PDBQT format. You have to give the center dimensions and you have to give the size. Alright, so for that, so the first thing you need to do is, you need to write ligand. Alright, so as I had saved the receptor in the protein, so I will just write down as protein, and also I have my ligand in ligand. Also, I have saved my ligand in ligand.pdbqt, so it's all right. And now the most important thing is the x, y, and z dimension. So for that, open your Discovery Studio. Alright, and then click SBD site sphere and then attributes. Now copy these. So first of all, I will copy these dimensions and paste it in the configuration file. Alright, so just remove it and press Ctrl V. Again Y. Dimension, press copy and then Control V. Lastly, Z. Delete it and then Discovery Studio. Again, select this dimension. Copy and then now, alright, so now we have placed the center dimensions x, y, and z, and as the size of the radius here, you can see the radius is 15. So I'm not going, so it would be better if you choose your size to be 20 and the exhaustiveness is 8. After that, save this in the name of configuration. So I had write it as confi and then save. Yes, all right. After this, so now we have our configuration file, we have a protein, ligand, and all this. Now, the next thing, all right, so once you are done with your configuration file, next thing you need to do is you need to open command prompt. So, in the search menu, so search command prompt. Is a command prompt, open it. Alright, so this kind of interface will come. Now you need to, now here you need to place this file location so that it can read all these necessary files. So what you need to do is just press just move your cursor beside docking and then select and then copy. All right, and then open your command prompt. All right, and then write down as cd space and then press Control V. All right, after this press enter. All right, so you can see this will come, so this file name will appear here. Now after that, write down as vena dot exe. All right, after that give space and then dash dash. All right, after that write config space. Now what? Now just wrote down the name which you had used. So here you can see it is confi. All right. So I'm writing it as confi dot tx. Confi dot txt. All right. After then again give space and then dash log space log dot txt. It will be basically your log file. After that press enter and wait for some time. Now alright, so you can see it is running, it is analyzing the binding site. Alright, so this is the simplest way in which you can run Autodoc Veena, and I think by using this method everyone will be able to run Autodoc Veena. Alright, just practice it in your home, just do it once or twice and you will get the results. Alright, so you can see the results are done and we have our output file generated. Alright, so you can see the binding affinity, it's -8.7 and it's pretty good binding score. Alright, with 0 RMSD, it's the best binding score of -8.7. Alright, so now you can see we have our result generated in the form of output and it is in the PDBQT format here. All right, now if you want to add all these 9 scores, so for that you need to split this output file in terms of each and every pose it has run. So for that what you need to do is here in command prompt wrote down as Veena under hyphen and then split dot exe executable file, give space and then dash dash and then wrote down input. So what will be the input? The input here will be our output file. So it is out, give space and then wrote down as out dot PDB QT and then press enter. Alright, so you can see the prefix for ligands will be out dot ligand, out dash ligand, and prefix for flexible side chains will be out flex. So you can see out ligand 1, ligand 2, all the 9 ligand pose has been generated and now you can analyze it. And now you can analyze all this using Discovery Studio. All right. So now again, we will need Discovery Studio in order to analyze the results. All right. So what I'm going to do is, first thing we need to do is we need to select the protein. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to close it. And after that, file open and then press and then choose the protein from here. All right, so we have our protein here and now I will choose all the 9 out ligand poses. All right, so I will select all these out and then press shift and then open. So it will open all these ligand in separate windows and later we will copy it in a single place. Alright, so we have all the 9 output ligand. So first of all, what I need to do is I need to copy this out ligand 1. So left. So for that, press left click and then copy. And then choose the protein, click on view and then hierarchy, and then paste it here. Alright, so out ligand 1 has been placed. Now out 2, copy and paste. Alright, so I'm closing this out ligand 1 and out ligand 2. So out ligand 3, again copy and paste. Alright, so we have placed all the 9 out ligand in a single place with our protein. And now you can see these are the various conformations of the ligands. If you want to do full screen, you can do that. So click on view and then full screen. Alright, so here you can see these are the 9 ligands. So these are the pose of the 9 ligands. And now in order to exit, press escape. Alright. After this, only one ligand. If you want to analyze ligand 1. So just click on it and remove the tick from others. This is the ligand 1, and if I see the command, so the ligand 1 has -8.7, has the affinity of -8.7. Alright, so this one is ligand 1 and this is the pose. Alright, so now here you can analyze the interaction diagram. That is for that. Now in order to analyze the interaction diagram, what you need to do is you need to move on to view interactions and then select this out ligand 1 and this. So you can see the receptor is protein here and the ligand is out ligand 1. All right after this, click on ligand interaction. Alright, so yeah, here you can see the ligand interaction. So now here you can see the ligand interaction. Also, if you want to see the data table, so here you will find here you can see this yellow color is basically lysine. And wait a second, I will increase its size. Yes. So here you can see the electrostatic interaction, the hydrophobic interaction, this pi cation stacking, and you can also see the distances. Right, so you can get these data. So this is a data table which will be very much useful. And these are basically the interactions. Now if you want to have these interaction, if you want to see this interaction in terms of 2D diagram, so for that click on show 2D diagram and it will show you this kind of image. And yeah, it's pretty good, especially when you are writing thesis or dissertation and you need to place the interactions of the ligand with the side chain residues, then this 2D diagram proves to be very much useful. So this is pi cation, pi anion, pi sigma, pi pi stacking, pi pi T shaped. Alright, all these informations have been provided. You can just save this image. You can take screenshot and then save this image and then place it in any of your Word or PowerPoint presentation. Alright, if now let's say if you want to analyze the second pose. So remove this from here. And then again, so this is out ligand 2 and it will show you the interactions with the side chains. You can see ligand interactions, and so this is the ligand interaction. And if you want to see the 2D diagram, it here. So here it is interacting with proline, tyrosine. Alright, so here you will find all these. So I think this is really very much useful. Also, one thing I forgot to mention, if you want publication quality image, so what will you need to do? So now in order to have publication quality image, you need to go to scripts and then visualization and then publication quality. Alright, so now here you can see this one is the image for publication quality. Alright, I had seen many, you will find this kind of publication quality, you will find these kind of publication quality images in various journals. They prefer BioRia Discovery Studio in order to publish their work, and it usually provides better results. All right, so I hope this video is beneficial to all of you, and after watching this video you will be able to run Autodoc Veeam.